Thank you for keeping it short. If we do that, many of us will get a chance to speak. Honorable Robert Mbui, member for Kathiani.
Thank you, Madam Speaker, for the opportunity, for also getting to contribute to this very, very serious motion. Madam Speaker, any country that wants to grow and to progress obviously has to invest heavily in education. I mean, some of the countries that were similar to Kenya at independence, the Malaysians of this world, invested properly in education. And this is a sector, like the minority whip said, we cannot play around with it. The fact is that there is a major crisis, and there's a crisis in the implementation of the CBC system. And the worst thing about it, Madam Speaker, is that this is not a system that started last year. This is a system that started 7 years ago. So 7 years ago, those honchos in Elimu House knew that there would be junior secondary, they knew there would be senior secondary, and they knew they had to prepare for it. But Madam Speaker, what I am seeing is a spirit of confusion, which we must find a way to deal with. Because look, Madam Speaker, first and foremost, because I want to qualify the spirit of confusion, JSS classes were built in secondary schools. Then the implementation of JSS now is being done in primary schools, where there are no classes. Madam Speaker, grade standards, class 7 students are in primary school, I mean are in secondary school, while class 8 students are still in primary school. Madam Speaker, further confusion is when you find class 7 students wearing trousers and our bigger brothers, their bigger brothers are still in shorts, you know, in a more junior school. And let me tell you, I've observed this, that the Ministry of Education came up with a plan and they said, not every primary school will be allowed to have junior secondary school. So they said that in some of the schools, the children will be moved to other schools. What has happened is that grade 7 students have left a school which had a class that was already built with teachers, have gone to another school where there is no new class, they've increased the population in that class, and there are no extra teachers. I mean, what is more confusing than that? Madam Speaker, I think we really have a problem. And then, of course, my colleague, the Honorable Kaluma, said that the idea of a teacher teaching 14 subjects is totally an unusual and totally impossible. So, Madam Speaker, I think it's important that we deal with this thing properly. There are not even enough textbooks. Madam Speaker, some of the subjects, like art and music, don't even have textbooks up to now, because nobody wants to invest in something that is going to be optional, and they're not too sure how many people will buy. So we have a problem even of the basic materials required for this system. And Madam Speaker, what has happened and what is most annoying for us is during this period of drought and hardship, head teachers in some of these schools have taken advantage, introduced admission fees, introduced fees for new uniform, and uniform is not necessary. Children can finish school with the clothes they were wearing before. They have to carry new lockers. They could have used the ones that they were using before. And now they've even introduced school feeding programs, because now they're in grade 7, it is called secondary, now they have to start paying fees. It's really unfortunate. It's something that we need to completely condemn with the strongest terms possible. So Madam Speaker, for me, I think the rain started beating us when we allowed the Ministry of Education to completely disregard Article 94, Part 5, which says that no person can make provision having the force of law except Parliament. If we had put our foot down when this thing was being started, we'd have been able to discuss further and been able to sort it out. My proposal is that all primary schools must be allowed, Madam Speaker, to continue having junior secondary schools. The idea of moving children from one school to another, I think it's preposterous. It is important that they continue where they are. I heard the chair of education saying, when a child starts in grade 1, they should go all the way up to grade 9 and all the way up to grade 12. Why are they then chasing them now? You know, a lot of children will drop out. A lot of children are discouraged. So it's important that we do that. And finally, we must invest in classes and labs in all our primary schools for this system to work. Otherwise, Madam Speaker, we need to deal with the confusion. Maybe we may put it up for prayers, because I know we are a praying nation. Thank you, Madam Speaker.
Majority Whip.
Thank you, Honorable Speaker. Honorable Speaker, this is the very first time I'm tempted to agree with Honorable Robert Mbui. And I don't know how, from what side he woke up this morning, because we seem to be agreeing everything the entire day, from the morning interview on Citizen and now about CBC. And with this trend, he'll also agree with me that William Ruto is the president, because we are agreeing virtually over everything. But Honorable Speaker, this thing about CBC is something that really this House needs to make a serious recommendation and stand firm over it. And it's becoming something that is very, very expensive. Majority of the members of this House happen to represent constituencies from remote areas, you know, different places. You know, the way our country is set up in such a way that most of the constituencies are from the rural areas. And but when you look at the formation and the structure of CBC, it focuses on the targets of the rich and the people who live within the urban setup. I think for some reason, Honorable Speaker, somebody wanted to rush this whole thing about CBC for whatever reason that befits them then. And I think it's important for government to realize that this, it wasn't part of our plan, by the way. This wasn't part of the Kenyan plan. It wasn't part of the manifesto by the Kenya Kwanza. This was a setup. This was a hub for somebody to make money in the previous administration. And there is need for us to review that. It's very important for this education committee that sit here to realize that, because parents are struggling. Back in the village, parents are struggling. We all represent constituencies.